invite you to join over 300,000 people now gathering from all over the city to a concert complete with the 1812 overture by Tchaikovsky with bells and cannons and fireworks. And now to the Esplanade. Washington Post March by John Philip Sousa. Arthur Fiedler conducted the Boston Pops. Next, a suite from the water music by Handel, arranged by Hardy. The movements are Allegro, Air, and Allegro Deciso. Arthur Fiedler and the Boston Pops with Suite from the Water music by Handel, arranged by Harty on This Evening at Pops special from Boston's Patch Memorial Shell. Now a Strauss waltz, Voices of Spring. Voices of Spring Waltzes by Strauss. Arthur Fiedler conducted the Boston Pops. Next, Overture to Orpheus in Hades by Offenbach.
Thank you.
Overture to Orpheus in Hades by Offenbach. Arthur Fiedler conducted the Boston Pops. Arthur Fiedler, who has been leader of the Boston Pops nearly half a century, joined the Boston Symphony in 1915 at the age of 20. It was in 1929 that he started these free outdoor concerts on the Esplanade, which, as you can see, 50 years later, are enthusiastically attended. Tonight's audience is estimated to be around 300,000. They've been collecting here since early this morning.
Operations to Helicopter 2. We'd like a report, if you will, please, as to what the traffic is coming into the Esplanade area at this time. The NBC police would like to know.
Roger. We estimate 15 to 20,000 people by the hatch shell at this time and building.
What you're seeing behind me is the Esplanade and the Charles River Banks of Boston. And what we're doing is throwing a party for approximately 300,000 people this afternoon. All of the various police and health and hospital and military police functions are up here. At this point, we are trying to coordinate all of the activities for tonight's Boston Pops concert and the 1812 Overture. We have howitzers provided by the 101st Field Artillery of the National Guard. They'll be shot on the riverbanks of the Charles River. We then bring in some church bells from the Church of the Advent on Brimmer Street, which is a very fine historic church in Boston. And there will be about 1,800 shells fired from four barges, probably about the largest fireworks show that has ever been shot in New England. In 1929, when Mr. Fiedler held his first Esplanade concert, there were about 8,000 people there. And to me, it's really incredible that something could have grown from those few 8,000 people into probably now their descendants, all beneath us on the grass here today. I've always had great respect for Arthur Fiedler, and especially his spirit of founding the Esplanade concerts for free and open to the public of all types from all areas of the city.
This is the first shell. It was built in 1929. And this is the second one. And this one, of course, is the one that we have at the moment. Shell number one, shell number two, shell number three.
He was a violin player for the Boston Symphony Orchestra, somewhere off in the ensemble. But he was an ambitious man with an idea that had never been tried before. Why not, he said, bring orchestral music to people of all classes, out of the symphony halls and into the open air? There'd been outdoor concerts in Boston before, brass bands with a lot of pa, but a real symphony orchestra, and for free? It was unheard of.
And so I thought the first thing to do is to try to raise some money. But that was very, very difficult. It took me 2 years just to raise enough money to pay the musicians for 1 year. And I appointed myself a very small salary because I really wanted to do the concert.
They built a shell for him made out of wood, a rickety piece of planking with the kinds of acoustics he wouldn't wish on an empty warehouse. Ugly, too. Some of the neighbors wanted it torn down right away.
But what we were worried about mostly was the type of audience we'd get. Policemen were dead against it. They thought it'd mean an awful lot of extra work, pulling in drunks and so on. Not a thing, nothing. Just sat around there listening to the music, stood up there.
It was a come-as-you-please symphony. People rented chairs for a dime or just sat down on the grass. No reserved seats, no preferred locations. Everybody, rich and poor, listening to the music, swatting mosquitoes. Very democratic.
I like that expression of Judge Capp, that he felt that for the first time in 300 years, the Boston public had actually gotten together and rubbed elbows.
That's what I wanted. There were no bars attached. There were no entrances, no gates, nothing. It's wide open. Sit where you want. That's what I want.
The idea worked. He brought symphonic music to the people, and the people to symphonic music. Over 8,000 of them that first night. More than two packed houses at Symphony Hall.
We did everything we possibly could. It's impossible to do everything. But it was a concert, anyway. wasn't perhaps the most memorable concert. To me, it was. But you do the best you can always. I always do the best I can.
A few years later, they replaced the wooden shell with a steel one. And in 1940, they dedicated the Hatch Memorial Shell, the one we use today, all of them filling the summer esplanade with sound. Long before Fiedler could provide all that music, though, Boston had to provide some place it could be played. It wasn't so long ago that the esplanade itself didn't even exist.
We used to come out here and try to kill muskrats, because the houses on Beacon Street, they came right to the water's edge, you know, just with a wooden fence. It was very ugly and very unhealthy, I think. It's beautiful now.
Around 1910, they put the finishing touches on the Charles River Dam. It gave Boston 1,000 acres of open water park right in the heart of the city's most congested district. And in the 30s, a $1 million gift came along, and that meant more parks, more playgrounds, more beaches, more boating, and the widening of the esplanade. Enough room to put the new Hatch Shell on. Of course, if it hadn't have been for Fiedler and his concerts, the shell would probably never have been built at all. As more and more people started coming to the concerts, they built a footbridge to get them there safely. And that one they dedicated to Fiedler.
When Fiedler was there to open the season, he pointed to that bronze tablet. He said, you know, what I like about that is it points out that I am a native Bostonian. And he said, come to think of it, I think that this is the greatest achievement of my career. These concerts.
The concerts started in the last year of the Coolidge boom. They weathered the Depression without missing a season. They carried on through the dim out of the Second World War, 50 years without a stop.
He took pride in those concerts as if he were presiding over a little kingdom of beautiful people.
They were full of them. Kids on the arms and kids in perambulators all over the place. And they got their first taste for music that way and come going nicely because it was free, it was something to do. Then came the Depression, and nobody had a dime even for a chair, and everybody came here because of some way to spend the evening.
The audiences went along with him. They were hearing new sounds, new effects, and they liked it. And they would view that as a matter, not of an orchestra playing, but that was Fiedler. He was giving them this experience.
We had tremendous crowds of uniformed people and a lot of nurses from the hospitals and so forth. And they were so glad to have something to do and not need the money to do it with either. They were a very good audience from all over the country.
The sun would go down and then the moon comes. And it was partly what you heard, partly what you saw, partly being with people. The whole thing blended together.
People were in a very good mood, very friendly. I don't know how many letters I got from people that said they met their future wife or husband on the esplanade, and I said, how did you do it? Well, I lit a cigarette for her, and then we went over, had a little soda somewhere and so on, and then friendship broke, started that way. I said, I hope it still lasts.
I believe that the esplanade concerts have been and still are honestly, heartfeltly, considered by Arthur Fiedler to be the greatest accomplishment of his musical career. I agree with that.
That's what I wanted. There were no bars attached. There were no entrances, no gates, nothing. It was wide open. Sit where you want. That's what I wanted. It worked out very well.
From the Cat's Memorial Shell in Boston, this evening at Pop Special, will be continuing with a featured work, the 1812 Overture by Tchaikovsky, complete with bells and cannons and fireworks. We'll be back with part two in just a moment. This is PBS, the Public Broadcasting Service.
This evening at Pop Special is made possible by a grant from Martin Marietta Corporation.
We're back for part two of this evening at Pop Special from Boston's Hat Shell on the Esplanade with Arthur Fiedler and the Boston Pops Orchestra. These concerts were started by Arthur Fiedler July 4th, 1929. Here again is Arthur Fiedler. Anthem, beginning part two of this Esplanade concert. And now a Pops arrangement of American country music, Pops Hoedown. Pops Hoedown, arranged for the Pops by Richard Heyman. Arthur Fiedler conducted the Boston Pops.
Track polka by Edward Strauss.
Track polka by Strauss. Arthur Fiedler conducted the Boston Pops.
We will sing a medley, and we wish you would all join us, called America Sings. You may have it in your program, I'm not sure.
Thank you. the 1812 Overture by Peter Ilyich Tchaikovsky.
Thank you.
the 1812 Overture by Tchaikovsky. Arthur Fiedler conducted the Boston Pops with assistance from the Church of the Advent Bells, the Howitzers from the Massachusetts National Guard, and fireworks from Boston's Hatch Memorial Shell on the Esplanade. The Beethoven by Murphy, arranged for the Pops by Richard Heyman. And to close this evening a Pop special, the Stars and Stripes Forever March by Sousa. Stars and Stripes by Sousa. Arthur Fiedler conducted the Boston Pops. Fiedler is back for another bow. We come to the end of this evening of Pop Special from the Hat Shell in Boston on the Esplanade, celebrating 50 years of free public concerts with Arthur Fiedler and the Boston Pops Orchestra. These concerts were founded by Arthur Fiedler, July 4th, 1929. From Boston's Esplanade, this is William Pierce speaking.
This evening at Pop Special was made possible by a grant from Martin Marietta Corporation.